Hey everybody, it's Lance coming to you from my home here in Austin, Texas. And I know usually we're here talking about guitar equipment, but I have something I need to share with all of you today, and it is about Jeep. It is about the Jeep Corporation, specifically about the 2015 Jeep Cherokee Sport, and about my least favorite car dealer in the world, South Point Chrysler Dodge Jeep in South Austin, Texas. So I purchased this Jeep about a year ago, and Lisa, my wife, and I were on our way to Dallas at about 10,000 miles on this brand new car. It still smelled like new car smell, and a warning light came on that said transmission needs service. Well, not only did it need service, it left us on the side of the road in Dallas at 10,000 miles, and luckily the people at Love Field Jeep were able to get the car, and they were able to get it working overnight. However, the problem didn't end there. The car jumps from first to third gear when you start. So what does that mean for a normal person like us? You have an automatic transmission, and if you're in traffic and you have your foot on the brake, you let your foot off the brake and touch the gas, you can jump from first to third gear and jump a car length and rear end somebody. We've had to be very careful with this car. It also jumps from third to first, so when you're braking, it feels like you're like a teenage kid trying to learn to drive a stick. Absolutely unacceptable for a brand new car. So I'm thinking to myself, of course Jeep's gonna fix this. So I called Jeep, South Point in Austin, Jeep, and I said, hey, here's what's going on. I need to get my car fixed. And they said, we have one transmission guy in the city, and you can leave it with us for 3 weeks and we'll look at it. But here's the catch, guys. We won't give you a loaner car. So this is a car with a full warranty that's brand new, right off the lot. They won't give me a loaner, and they want to keep my car for 3 weeks. So I told them I would call back because that's unacceptable and I'd have to try it another time. So about 4 weeks later, I called and said, how about now? Nope, there's still one guy that works on transmissions, and he's here occasionally, and you'll have to leave your car for 3 weeks and we won't give you a loaner car. So I called Jeep National, and Jeep National was like, oh my God, we're going to get to the bottom of this. They had me call a different dealership in town who gave me the same runaround. So this is going on for months now, and I'm driving this car that has an issue. So I called a Lemon Law attorney. Lemon Law attorney writes a letter to South Point. South Point then apparently gets all butthurt over that, and when I called National again and said, I really need to get this fixed, they said, go to South Point where you purchased the car, and we will make them work on the car. What do? The next morning I wake up early, I fight traffic with the car bouncing in and out of first and third gear over to their lot. And the kid that was working on it said, we're not going to work on your car. And I said, why not? You had a lawyer contact us. And I said, get your service manager. Service manager comes out. He's extremely flippant. And he tells me they're not going to work on my car. Now, this is a car with a 100,000 mile warranty on the drivetrain, and they won't work on the drivetrain. So not to bore you guys, but I've been through probably 100 hours of calls with Jeep National, Chrysler Credit. It's been insane. They sent me up to Covert Jeep after that, and Covert, nice people, did work on it. But guess what? Jeep has now admitted to me that this is a problem they cannot fix. Okay, so it's an inherent problem that isn't all of these. There's a problem with the transmission, and it's a hazard. It's a danger. So I said, okay, so what are we going to do about it? They said, if you take it to Covert and they can't fix it, we'll escalate the problem and get you out of the car. I have that on tape, people from Jeep. I tape my conversations. Next day, of course, it's doing the same thing after I got back from Covert. And what did they say to me? I'm sorry, you're over the amount of mileage that you can use the Lemon Law on us, and we're not going to do anything for you. We'll let you know if and when there's a fix. I said, if and when there's a fix on a car that I paid retail for off the lot in Austin, Texas, less than a year ago, and now it's 24,000 miles. So bottom line is, what I'm saying to you guys is, if you have a Jeep Cherokee Sport 2015 model and it's doing that, call Jeep National and complain. This is going to get big. Everybody's going to find out their cars have problems, and they're going to try to keep us from getting them fixed, but we're not going to do that. We're going to go forward and we're going to get this done. As far as South Point goes, I'm hiring a lawyer to sue South Point. They sold me a Lemon. They won't stand behind it. They're extremely rude. In fact, as a sidebar issue, at one point the people from National tried to placate me a little bit, and they said, we'll give you 4 free oil changes and 4 tire rotations. I went in to get the free oil change, and this very cowboyish lady that works at South Point said, "I ain't never heard of that. That ain't true." Nice way to treat your customers, right? So long and the short of it is, do not buy a Jeep. This is the last one I'll ever buy that you see right here, and the minute I can get rid of this thing, I will. And if they don't do what they should do, which is give me my money back and take this car, or give me a car that works, Kurt's gonna be able to film me driving this back up there and handing them the keys. And I'm done. So guys, sorry to bore you with this. I'm Lance, thanks for your help. Spread this all over the internet, because Jeep's trying to pull a fast one on their customers, and we shouldn't let them. All right, I'm Lance, have a great day, bye-bye.